president today plans to detail a new task force to focus on the coronavirus economic challenges, including the delicate question of when at least part of the economy can reopen. And the Senate is debating today how to add even more money, $250 billion or so, into a program designed to help small businesses keep afloat. But there are some partisan differences there that need to be worked out. That's going to take a bit. Joining me now are CNN Chief Business Correspondent Christine Romans and Martha Gimbel. She's the Manager for Economic Research at Schmidt Futures. Christine, let me start with you. When you look at these numbers, it was 3 million, then it was 6 million, now it's 6 million again. Number one, they're just stunning and devastating. And number two, the infrastructure of the unemployment system is just not built to handle this.
No. I mean, because these numbers are just unthinkable. I mean, who would ever build a state unemployment office to handle, you know, 400,000 jobless claims like in North Carolina? They're used to 3,000 a week. They got 400,000, the governor said. So the infrastructure just isn't there to handle this kind of flood. And every one of those numbers, John, what's so heartbreaking, every one of those numbers is a person who has bills to pay. And they are basically the social sacrifice for the big public health problem that's happening here. So it's really just an unusual, unthinkable situation to be in. And there's no playbook for it. You know, you'd like to believe what Jerome Powell is saying, that there could be a quick economic response someplace down the road. But right now, these are people who are being laid off and still haven't been able to secure their unemployment benefits just yet, or just now starting to get them. So I think we have a really kind of tough few weeks to get through here.
And Martha, to that point, the first priority is helping people who are in desperate need, individuals. And then there's all these businesses. All this money is designed to keep the businesses afloat. The president hopes they keep their employees, but at least to keep them afloat. You see the Senate back in today. They say $250 billion more just for small businesses. I mean, how much money are we talking about being essentially printed by the government and put out just to keep a foundation, not to keep the economy? It's not strong by any means.
Yeah, I mean, I think one thing that's really important to think about is that these aren't stimulus plans. They're support plans for the economy while it's in a medically induced coma and we can bring it back. To be frank, I think that $250 billion may end up not being enough. We know that small businesses are already struggling. They're already going out of business. And it seems likely that the federal government is going to have to spend likely trillions more dollars to keep workers and businesses going.
And what do we know? And I know there's a lot of things we don't know right now because we don't know how long this closure is going to last. We don't know how long we're going to be going through this. But you listen to Jerome Powell, he says fairly quick. The president likes to say like a rocket that he's going to flip a switch and the economy is going to go back to where it was like a rocket. Listen to Bill Gates this morning, who knows very well the American economy is consumer driven. Consumers are scared. Even as baseball plans to reopen, it's talking about doing it without fans. Bill Gates says this is going to take a while.
The behavior of people in terms of wanting to travel or go to events or even go to a restaurant, it's been utterly changed by the concerns about this disease. No one should think the government can wave a wand and all of a sudden, you know, the economy is anything like it was before this happened. That awaits either a miracle therapeutic that has an over 95% cure rate or broad usage of the vaccine.
Martha, let me start with you. Bill Gates, it sounds like it makes a lot more sense to me than we're going to take off like a rocket.
Yeah, I mean, I think that that's the right attitude. First of all, we have evidence from the 1918 flu pandemic that places that took much more stringent public health measures were able to recover much more quickly with respect to the economic situation. Also, you know, consumers just aren't going to go back out and start spending until they feel safe. And that's why I come back to, we need to be thinking about economic policy as support rather than stimulus. We're probably going to be in the situation for a really long time to come. And I think workers and businesses need to start adjusting to that reality, and the federal government needs to help them do that.
And Christine, help if you can connect the pieces. And again, I know a lot of this we just can't answer right now. But Canada's economic numbers, jobless numbers today, you know, it's a smaller country population-wise, but they're just as bleak. Britain's central bank is putting money into the economy just like the Fed is here. Airbus says it's going to stop or cut back a lot of production everywhere. There's a global piece of this puzzle that it's hard to wrap your mind around.
Yeah, usually when you have a crisis or a recession, which I'm sure we're already in a recession, there's somebody around the world that's the global leader, and you just don't see who's emerging as the global leader yet. But, you know, you want to avoid any kind of a false start, and the consumer spending part of it is so important here. Our polling yesterday showed that 60% of Americans said at the end of April they would not feel comfortable going back to their normal routine. So that's why you have to have testing, you have to have therapeutics, you have to have contact tracing and quarantines where necessary, antibody therapy so you know who can go back to work in important jobs, and a very carefully stage-managed reentry so that people are comfortable and they know that their government and their states are going to protect them and are for the best interests of everybody, not just for getting businesses up and running like flipping up a switch.
My consumer confidence now tied to progress on the health front as much as it is any confidence about the economy. Martha Gimbel, Christine Romans, really appreciate it on this depressing day when it comes to the numbers to get some important experience and insight. And a quick update for us now on a guest we had on the program earlier this week. You might remember William Walla was laid off from his job at a Texas oil and gas company, that because of a big drop in demand for oil. William explained to us days of frustration trying to file for benefits. He tried online, tried on the phone, tried at the local unemployment office, tried all of those things over and over again. William says after his interview here on CNN, he was contacted by someone who put him in direct contact with an official at the Texas Workforce Commission. And now William says he is enrolled to get his benefits and to get them backdated to the time when he lost his job. A little bit of good news there. Best of luck, William, in the days ahead and for all the people like him who are trying to get the help they need and deserve. Up next for us, new poll numbers today on the somewhat forgotten 2020 campaign. One thing they tell us, whether you think President Trump or Joe Biden would do a better job leading the country through this pandemic.